Treasurer Wayne Swan has indicated that his promise of a budget surplus next year could be broken. New tremors are running through the global economy and Australia may not be immune.
Chandeliers for a champagne economy.
Australia's position within the global financial community has never been stronger than it is today.
Picking up his gong as Global Finance Minister of the Year, Wayne Swan vowed to push on with the big reforms.
Even when they're tough, even when they're difficult.
But it was his big promise to restore the budget to surplus by next year that is now under heavy pressure. This was the government last budget time.
Back to surplus in 2012-13, on track, on time, and as promised.
We're delivering what we promised, the return to surplus back in the black in 2012-13.
This was the Treasurer today.
Common sense says that conditions have changed and that task gets more difficult because of global economic conditions.
This is going to turn out to be yet another Labor broken promise.
European and American debt is driving down global growth forecasts. The hit to tax revenues makes it much harder for Australia to claw back out of the red. But many economists say that's one promise it's okay to break.
As the situation changes, the facts change, then sometimes you have to be prepared to change your mind.
I don't think we do need to push into surplus at this current time, given the uncertainties abroad.
The opposition today urged the Reserve Bank to cut interest rates. But while a softening economy could hit jobs, one of the country's leading economists says the carbon tax will have virtually no impact on employment.
If you want to have a debate about carbon pricing, do not think about the jobs. The jobs issue is trivial.
Hugh Rimmington, 10 News.